Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all that has happened leading up to this moment. Here, oh God, we thank you for bringing us all here safely. We thank you for beautiful weather. We thank you for all your providence and your provision upon Fiona and Craig thus far, oh God. We thank you in Jesus' name we ask and pray.
Amen.
Oh, just before Fiona went down the aisle tonight, I actually stepped on her wheel.
I'd like to say firstly to welcome Fiona into the Crowder family. There's not many of us.
She turns heads wherever we go, and I'm slowly getting to grips with the fact that people on the street think I'm a bodyguard or something as she shops. And boy, can she shop. Wow.
Little did I know that that decision would lead to a dreamy wedding at a Scottish castle in freezing temperatures.
Hi, everybody. We are Lionel and Linda, Fiona's parents. Although this is the third time I'm walking a daughter down the aisle, it is still overwhelming to give my daughter away. As we looked at our daughter, we can't help but reflect on all the years we were blessed enough to watch her grow and become the beautiful woman she is today. Fiona has always been the one who helps me and Linda with the handy stuff around the house due to her height and strength. My other daughters used to tell me, you're treating Fiona as if she's your son.
For those of you who don't know me yet, my name is Mira. You should by now, because I've been talking all evening. I first met Fiona on her first day of college, some 11 to 12 years ago. She walked into the first day of class, and as fate would have it, sat next to Farhana and I. And for those of you wondering, yes, she's always been this beautiful. From the first week of college, we knew we'd all be best friends, as we had a lot of great things in common. For instance, we all took great pleasure in not paying attention in class. Now, I know she's shy in Monash, but there was a dark story behind that. But accounting and maths was when we really shined. I cannot begin to tell you the countless number of hours, effort and sweat we put into studying for exams night before the paper. And then trying our best not to pass out during the exam by putting medicated oil in ourselves as if it was some miracle drug of some sort.
So actually, Craig and I met a few years ago in 2016, it was already, I think. 14, no, I'm really getting old, you see. No, and we got stuck together in this really nice place called Nigeria. Now, if you know Nigeria, you know that the only place where you can be is in the hotel and actually at work. So after being there for almost more than a year, stuck every day in a hotel room together, I got to know Craig as a person that was giving me a lot of advice on my relationship, even though he was not having a relationship at the time.
Anyone would notice Fiona anywhere. This is because she always walks with confidence and God's authority. Also, she had an amazing fashion sense. I'm quite certain she has never worn the same dress twice. All the best, Craig.
Craig, I thought I should have a dig at you. Because we met almost a year back. And the guy came into our house. He was so relaxed. And he made me relax in my own house. I mean, he made his bed, he did washing, You know, he did cleaning and everything. He made me so relaxed. You know, I welcome you again.
Now, on 2nd March 2016, Fiona and Craig met for the first time. Though Craig didn't leave an entirely lasting impression on Fiona, our man was persistent.
You've probably gathered over the course of today that Fiona and I's relationship was not necessarily very public from the very start.
So in Oman, and our friendship kind of deepened out a little bit, although I did notice that he was chatting less with me and he was looking more and more at his phone. Because there seemed to be some kind of distraction going on there. Then the next thing is, instead of flying back west, he started flying more east more and more to KL. And I have never asked him to do any work for me in KL. So, yeah.
Now, a few weeks after they had just met, we're on Europe for a trip. And when we checked into our hotel room in Rome, there was an incredibly extravagant gift waiting there. And this was when I first took notice of Craig.
And it quickly became apparent to me that Fee was the person I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. But there were a couple of issues we had to address. And one was the fact that Fee was in Malaysia. I was initially in the UK. Fee stated very clearly that she didn't do long distance relationships. But the second and less obvious issue was that, and I'm sure this will come as a surprise to most of you, there is a slight age difference between Fiona and I. And while that wasn't an issue for Fiona, it's fair to say she had some concerns as to how her family would feel about this. So over time, bit by bit, friends and family started to learn a little bit more about me, all except Mum and Dad. And then the Lord intervened. When Fiona rang to tell me her broken foot news, I announced to her, I'm coming to Malaysia. I said, you can decide what you want to tell them, but I'm coming. So I did, and she did. She told them I was a work colleague who was flying in from Oman to visit her.
But as I sat in that hospital room, I can never forget the way Craig looked at our girl. There was something different about him, and no camera could have captured the amount of love, care, and respect Craig radiated, not just for Fiona, but also for a mother and father with whom he had just met.
Marriage is like a garden. If you look outside, there's so many gardens out here. And these gardens don't take care of itself. It needs tending. It needs a lot of work, enough water, and a lot of the sun. S-O-N, sun.
Frederick Martin Crowther.
Take you,
Fiona Lewis.
Fiona Lewis.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I, Fiona Lewis.
Take you.
Take you.
Craig Martin Crowther.
Craig Martin Crowther.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And by the virtue of these declarations made in my presence and in the presence of your witnesses and guests, I now have the very great pleasure of pronouncing you husband and wife. You may kiss.
Craig and Fiona, we all love you very much. Your life together begins now and will take many turns. You will have ups, you will have downs, but in the end you will have each other and you will always have God to look to. Be true to each other always. Share your joys and your burdens. Be each other's best friend. With all my heart and mum's beloved, we wish above all that you would prosper and be in health even as your soul prospers.
And most of all, I hope that she would find someone who loves her for her, but also recognizes that she is truly a friend, a daughter, an aunt, a cousin, and a soulmate is one in a million. And during all those years of knowing Fiona, I may have not known it yet, but I was still hoping for you, Craig. And I'm so grateful that you found each other, fell in love. And we are here today living out your fairytale destination wedding all the way in a castle in Edinburgh, Scotland.
And what can I say about Fiona? This is the bit she's scared about. You've probably gathered from today and my speech so far that I'm head over heels in love with her. She is amazing. Composure. Stunningly beautiful, with amazing hair and that infectious laugh. I genuinely barely breathed when I saw her walking down the aisle today. Mira asked me to answer a load of questions about Fi and our relationship. One of the questions was, how has Fiona made me a better person since we met? If I haven't cried already, and I have come close, I'm pretty sure this is where I go. My answer was simple and honest. Being quite a bit older, I'd become quite cynical and had little joy in my life. Fi has made me love life again in a new and special way. Sorry, 2 seconds. I will make it to the end. Every day with her helps me to be a better person and a better Christian. I am so excited about our future. So many new countries and places to visit, and food to eat and photograph.
Whatever plans God has in store for us, I simply cannot wait for it all, and I feel truly blessed to be able to call you my wife.